Man, the crowd is so excited about this fight.
Alvarez looks to be switching. Serronio's got very much a karate style.
I'm going to go out on a limb and say that Serronio's a college student out there with the nobody on the knee guys.
Real good. Yeah.
But point fighters are dangerous, man. Good ones like this.
Woo!
Quick side kick and face.
It would serve Alvarez well to do leg kicks to that lead leg.
Totally.
And that stance right there, because he's putting a lot of pressure on that front leg. It's a real wide stance.
And he has the angle. Yeah. He can hit it on the inside or the outside.
And it would serve him well because this kid's got good movement, obviously. He's just going to have to commit to that leg kick, though. He can't halfway that. He's going to have to get his hands in his face and commit. Yeah, Serrano really likes that. There you go.
And Serrano's reaching for that leg kick. He needs to change that up. Take it to the leg, go back on top to the head.
Nice. Nice leg kick from Serrano.
Alvarez needs to
Alvarez is tough, man. He took a big shot, and he
took three big shots.
A couple more big shots. He's a tough kid, man. He's trying to clear himself, takes another right hand.
Serrano's got a beautiful two that he just throws straight down the pipe. He's really quick on the way he comes in with it.
Big, nice, heavy leg kick from Alvarez. Alvarez showing some heart right now. Serrano jumps in for a takedown with about 10 seconds left. Alvarez is trying to secure a guillotine that is probably not going to happen. There's the time for the first round.
Man, it can be really difficult to go against someone with that stance when you're really used to someone who's got a straightforward Muay Thai stance.
Back and forth. You know, and it's hard to, you think you could time them because they got such a rhythm. On that note, I'm going to take a minute to shout out to my tattoo artist and clothing designer, Sefa Samatua, because my shirt is hot. And I'm looking fly, baby.
You can fly between the tattoo and the shirt. You killing
it. I'm telling you. I'll be back in his chair on Wednesday. I'm excited, Sefa. I'll be down there.
Round two, guys. Alvarez in the red, Serronio in the blue.
I wonder what Alvarez's corner told him.
Well, he's already come out in a switch stance. So he's already changed his stance up. Which definitely changes up the angles because now they're in what's called a, I call it a closed stance rather than an open stance, which changes up at the angles. So right away, Alvarez is going to need to kind of get in the pocket. He needs to close the gap.
That's what I was thinking. He needs to get close.
Yep. He needs to stay out of the range of the feet. Because Serronio, he throws hard, but he throws one shot and then the hands drop. So he needs to get in there, put some combos together if he plans to stay in this fight. Because it's quite obvious that the strength of Serronio is real strong, quick, single strike.
I think if I was Alvarez, I would try to fake coming in so that I could get my opponent to throw one of those kicks, and then in that lull that you were talking about, go for it.
Yeah, he needs to attack on the recoil, but he's not making any movements to set up that.
Well, Alvarez is on, Serrano's in on a tight body lock that Alvarez is trying to peel off. Got away with a little bit of a cage grab there for a second. His feet are a little too close together. He's susceptible to some inside leg sweep if he wants it. But. Serenio dropped levels, got the double leg. Alvarez is really trying to hang on to his head, but again, I don't think he's going to make anything happen unless he can get his hips out and regain guard, which is what he's trying to do, it looks like.
What I'm really noticing about Alvarez is he is gassed. The mouthpiece is hanging out. He's squeezing with all his might right now. He might want to let that go and try to save some of that energy.
At the last 10 seconds, though, it's not the worst plan.
No. Hang on to that head for 10 seconds. Just take some of the air out of it. I have Alvarez down two rounds right now. Serrano's winning two rounds.
I agree.
I don't know if Alvarez has the power to put him out or not. But based upon what I just saw, it may not hurt Alvarez to go for a takedown on his own.
But I got to tell you, Serrano is clearly in good shape because he's not even winded, man. He looks like he can go four more rounds here. It's where you look across the cage and Alvarez is just sucking air.
Alvarez definitely looks like the more tired of the two fighters, but he's got a lot of... I'm really impressed with his chin because he's taking some pretty big shots off that straight right hand of Serrano. Yeah. He's eating him.
What's nice about Serrano is you notice he really knows the range. He knows how far he is away. Because he's like, sometimes he doesn't even pick his hands up. He just knows how far he's moving out of the ring. And that's that point fight experience.
Yep. Yeah, Alvarez really needs to just kind of throw caution to the wind at this point.
You know, I feel like that's what he's been doing, progressing as the fight goes on. But it might be... a little bit too late.
Yeah. Feet are really close together right now.
Yeah.
And there goes the takedown. And Alvarez is hanging on to that head, which is not the best idea. It looks like he finally did let go of it. Just really working to try and get that half guard or get full guard back. Serrano's doing a good job. Nice, good top position. Not really in any rush.
Whoa. Wow.
Wow. Wow. I'm a little surprised at how quickly he stood that up.
Big takedown. Clearly Serrano wanted to be on the ground. He just took him down.
And goes right back into side control. Boy, Killer B is really pushing for the action down there, you know?
Yeah.
Nice roll from Alvarez.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. He needs to do something. He's only got 10 seconds left. He's in trouble. Well, hey, we got to see a decision fight.
Action-packed fight. Great job on behalf of both guys.
Yeah, I have Serrano winning that three rounds of nothing.
Yeah,
but again,
but I'm still questioning, why did Killer B stand up? It wasn't like there was a low in the action.
Wilson is going to be bringing us our decision.
Well, the crowd is very surprised here. I'm pretty surprised. It looks like even the judges are pretty surprised.
I think that there may have been a...
I think there was an error.
I think that's a... Yeah, that's Wayne Wilson. I'm like, come on, there's no way. Like, that was an announcer error. That had to have been an announcer error on that.
And those happen.
Oh, yeah. Those cards can be real hard to read depending upon how they're doing it. So, mistakes happen, but yeah.